since the second wave began, the market has seen a few correction days and has continued to remain volatile. So how does one invest during these times? This is exactly the topic of today's webinar. A little about me, I am the co-founder of Tezi Mandi and I also lead the product team here. We launched Tezi Mandi in January and we have around 2000 plus investors in our portfolio and have over 1 lakh downloads of our app. Today's topic will be discussed by our founder and chief investment officer, Vaibhav. Vaibhav has over 10 years of experience in the capital markets and also leads the overall fund management of our portfolio. If you have any questions about our product or fund management style, you can ask them in the Q&A below. We will answer them at the end of the webinar. Without further ado, I hand it over to Vaibhav.
Hi, everyone. Welcome to this session by Tezi Mandi. I hope you guys are all safe. You know, we're all in the middle of the second wave of COVID and, you know, there are bouts of lockdown. So, you know, that's the topic that I'm going to address today, that in the backdrop of all of this, you know, how should we look at all of this from the perspective of the stock markets? And, you know, how should we invest in the and how should we kind of invest? So, you know, as you can see, it's, you know, the first wave of COVID was unknown for both the citizens, the doctors, and for the government. You know, it was a completely new, unknown situation. You know, also because the government had no way to know what was going on, you know, they did a total lockdown, which was basically, you know, a financial disaster for the entire country. The good part is in the second wave, you know, COVID is a known devil. You know, it has been observed very closely, you know, both globally and in India. So protocols are known to citizens, to the medical fraternity, and to the government. You know, at the highest levels of government, it has been indicated that there is no, that there is going to be no national level lockdown. You know, even including, you know, the finance minister, Mrs. Sitaraman, had also said the same. So I think the good part is that there will be no nationalized lockdown. But the issue is that, you know, there are going to be short bouts of localized lockdowns. Now, you know, so kind of just to kind of reiterate, you know, the problem with the current lockdowns is that, you know, like in places like Mumbai and maybe even places like, you know, Madhya Pradesh and UP, you know, there are certain, you know, kind of districts which are more affected than others. And that's why there are these bouts of localized lockdown. Now, the good part about it is that the vaccination effort is on full swing. You know, it's only a question of probably 2 or 3 months before things normalize. You must have read in the papers as well that, you know, that people are basically, you know, the government is approving, you know, the Sputnik vaccine, even Pfizer and Moderna are looking to come into India. So, you know, even the vaccines like Covaxin and all of that are looking to increase their production in India. So it's only a matter of 2-3 months before a good part of the population is vaccinated. And also with these bouts of localized lockdown, you know, it is likely that COVID will kind of, at least the pace of increase will reduce. You know, just to give you some example, like in Mumbai, for example, the pace of doubling has increased now from 38 days to 42 days. And incrementally, cases are much lower than they were, say, a week back. So, you know, things obviously are grim and they will take time to normalize. But, you know, they are improving as we go along. Now, the important part to realize is that while the ground reality may remain slightly grim, it is improving at many levels. And markets are forward-looking mechanisms. So, you know, while there could be some short-term volatility, what we would suggest is that you should use these corrections to invest in the market. It's only, you know, a question of a few days before kind of things start looking normal. Now, the important thing to realize is that in this year's budget, the government has increased the deficit target to 9.5%. This is a paradigm shift in the thinking of the government. This is because, you know, now the government's focus is completely on growth and growth. You know, never in India's history has the government taken such a bold stance. And because of this, you know, this could actually be bigger than the 1991 reforms in India. And compared to 91, actually, India's economic position is far better. So, you know, the effects of what stance the government has taken is going to be felt for many years to come. Now, if we look at India's macroeconomic position, India has one of the lowest debt to GDP ratios compared to any of the large countries of the world. We have forex reserves of close to 600 billion. Now, if you read the minutes of the central bank or the governor's meetings, it is evident that the central bank has a dovish stance. What this means is that, you know, they are positive on India's economic growth for FY22 and beyond. Furthermore, there's the central bank is also sitting on surplus liquidity and forex reserves. So what this means is central bank is likely to keep interest rates low and the exchange rate in check. Also, you know, credit growth in India has been anemic at about 5 or 6%. This is one of the lowest in the last 20 to 30 years. So, you know, it's unlikely that it'll go lower from here. It means that it can only improve going forward. Also, India has a low current account deficit and low inflation. Now, what we believe is that, you know, India is on the cusp of a long growth cycle. Now, India's corporate profits to GDP are the lowest in several decades. Because of bad loans, earnings of several banks have dried up. Once the NPA cycle reverses, earnings of banks like State Bank can go up significantly. Also, the government, you know, has clearly indicated, a focus on capex, infra and roads, and this could have a multiplier effect on the economy. Good part is that we're starting an upcycle with low interest rates, low debt levels, and surplus liquidity. As I pointed out earlier, the last decade has been about corporate deleveraging. And that's why, as we go into an investment phase in the next 5 to 7 years, it's good that, you know, the companies have the capacity to take on additional debt. You know, the December quarter was the first in almost a decade where the earnings upgrades were higher than the earnings downgrades. So what that means is that, you know, analysts thought that or feel that more companies will have earnings increases than companies whose earnings will reduce. You know, so that's a very, very good sign. We are also in the midst of the result season now. So the fourth quarter, you know, will indicate how things are going further. Also, India's PE might look slightly elevated, but it's important to realize that we're sitting on deflated earnings and a long protracted growth cycle. That's why earnings and valuations should be looked on at a stock specific basis. If I was to look at the history of the Nifty's earnings, so if we take this phase, which is 92 to 2000, you know, this was the time when India came out of economic liberalization. And so the CAGR was, you know, close to about 13%. It was a very choppy time. Now, if we move to the 2000s, you know, the first 3 years of that decade were obviously a little slow, but what we saw from 2003 to 2007 were the golden years of India's, capex infrastructure boom. It took India to a different trajectory altogether. And folks who were invested at that time did make meaningful returns in the market. Now, if we look at the last decade, which is FY10 to FY20, you know, we've had a very kind of, again, it's been anemic growth. It's not been, at the level of an earnings upcycle. If we look at FY21, I think the assumptions are, close to about 70% kind of earnings growth for the Nifty, which has not been seen for over a decade now. So what this means is, given the ingredients, just as I explained, we are at the bottom of an earnings upcycle. We're at the bottom of an economic cycle. Next 5 to 7 years could look very, very attractive for India. And if we go by history, you know, FI03 to FI07 is kind of something we can look back to. But this time, you know, the growth is only going to be stronger. The government has also laid like a far deeper base for growth. You know, even the earnings and, you know, the resilience and agility of corporate India is far better than what it was in 2003 to 2007. So that's why, you know, it's important to keep this perspective in mind. Now, market view. Now, you know, markets have been volatile. It's important to realize that 7 to 10% corrections are very normal in a long run bull market. What we would suggest is that you should use this correction to buy stocks. Now, if you look at this table, so what we did is we took data from, you know, for the last 5 years, all the way from 2015 to 2021. And what we've seen is that whenever there has been, you know, a sharp drop of over 5 to 6%, the market has correspondingly rebounded, you know, in a very handsome way. Even if we take, you know, the last 1 year, you know, you take almost any time period in the last 1 year when the markets have fallen, there has been a corresponding pullback in the market. That's why what we are suggesting is that even now, you know, when markets are volatile, they are correcting. If you're sitting on the fences looking to invest, you should definitely start your investing journey. And if you know, if you are, you know, kind of hesitant to put additional money, we would suggest that this would be a great time to put it, because, you know, ultimately you have to remain invested in the market. So coming to one very important point, you know, the time spent in the market in the long run is way more important than timing the market. Now, historical studies across the world and across different markets have shown that, you know, the time spent in the market has way better results than timing the market. So if we take Nifty in the last 30 years, this has given you a return of, you know, about 12% compounded. And so what that means is that Nifty returns were close to about 30x. Now, out of these 10,900 days or 30 years, if you miss the 30 best days of the Nifty, your return would come down from 30x to 3x. You know, so, you know, this just points to one thing: your returns are vulnerable to you being present in the market on the best days of the market. And it is nearly impossible to predict what those days are going to be. You know, so that's why, I mean, you take any investor in India, any of the big investors, you will realize that the big money is made by being in the market and by being invested in the right kind of stocks. So, you know, now, you know, in the backdrop of all of this, you know, how can Teji Mandi help you? So just to give you a quick backdrop of Teji Mandi, we are a subsidiary of the Motilal Oswal Group, and we are a SEBI registered investment advisor. Now, you know, what is the need for Teji Mandi? So, you know, when we look at retail investors and we see, you know, the way people invest, what we've realized is that people take advice from their friends, they take it from their family, they might be part of some WhatsApp groups. You know, oftentimes you look at maybe platforms like CNBC or, you know, something else. And what ends up happening is that, you know, you might receive kind of fragmented information, and you might kind of just buy a stock on the basis of that. But what you have to realize is that the journey of making money in the stock market, you can divide it into four buckets. One is what to buy, second is why to buy, third is how much to buy, and fourth is when to sell. Now, most people get stuck in the first bucket, which is what to buy. The other three components, which are, you know, probably equally important, get completely left out. So that's why it's important to, you know, focus on the other three buckets as well. Also, you know, a lot of times, you know, people get stuck with laggards or stocks that are making losses. They're not able to get out of it at the right time, because you get emotionally attached to your stocks. So that's where you need kind of a professional help to kind of do that. Now, generally, this kind of professional help, at least at a good quality, is available for people who access PMS portfolios. Now, these portfolios, you know, are for high net worth individuals with ticket sizes upwards of 50 lakhs. You know, the costs are just exorbitant. You know, we get you all of this, you know, at a really, really affordable rate. I'll just explain to you how. So what is it that we do? We'll tell you which stocks to buy, when to buy, how much to buy, and when to sell. You can transact using your DMAT account. We support, you know, the top discount and full service brokers. Now, if we look at the Teji Mandi investing philosophy, it has two kind of important components. One is the stock picking side and one is the rebalancing side. The stock picking comprises of two things. One is tactical bets, which are companies that are relevant from a 3 to 6 month perspective. And then you have long-term winners, which are companies which are relevant from a longer-term kind of 12 to 18 month perspective. So now when we talk about tactical bets, this is generally, for companies or sectors that are relevant from a near-term perspective. Three important criteria could be industry consolidation. So, in cases where, there's a large, large private sector player who's basically gaining, a larger established entity in the sector who's gaining market share. So, for example, in banking, the large private sector banks are gaining significant market share on account of better, underwriting, aggressive provisioning and strong liability. Second is the government policy. So, a change in government policy can create opportunity for certain companies and sectors to innovate or expand. So, for example, a government ban on electronic products from China could benefit companies in the Indian electronic sector. Now, third could be, like an industry tailwind. So, for example, last year, external conditions were favorable for specific stocks. So, because of above average rainfall, Rabi crop was strong, this year. And so good crop production has led to, the tractor, fertilizer and agrochem companies doing well. So one example of such a stock is Ashok Leyland. The CV cycle is coming out of 3 years of degrowth because of axle load and BS6. And it was further accentuated by COVID. Now, Ashok Leyland over the last few years has, really spent, money and effort on modularizing its platform, making inventory leaner and reducing the working capital cycle. The company has also strategically added products in the LCV and MHCV range, thereby increasing its total addressable market. Now, we had entered the stock at about 70 rupees. Today, it's at about 112. So, there's been a gain of over 60%. Now coming to long-term winners, now these are companies, which have a proven growth track record of profits of over 1, 3, and 5 years. These companies should also have meaningful growth runway, visible. These companies should also have prudent capital allocation. What that means is that they should have displayed ROEs well upwards of 15%. We also look at some beaten down stocks. What this means is that in some cases, high quality stocks get beaten down disproportionately. So risk reward becomes interesting in such situations. One example of a long-term winner is HDFC Limited. Now, this is without a doubt one of India's greatest NBFCs. Not just that, it also has subsidiaries like HDFC Bank and HDFC Life, which are their sector leaders. Now, HDFC Limited also has one of the lowest cost of funding, which gives it a significant advantage over its competitors. Now, HDFC Limited is India's largest housing finance company. And in India, mortgage penetration is less than 10% of India's GDP. The cost of owning a house, so, what this means is if you take interest plus government subsidy plus tax deduction, is one of the lowest in 40 years, right? A young population in India gives companies like HDFC Limited a long runway for growth. Now, if you look at the stock analysis process at Teji Mandi, we track data from across 30 different sectors and subsectors. We do detailed balance sheet, income statement, and cash flow analysis. We run quantitative screeners across accounting, growth, and valuation parameters. And, we track real-time news of companies, earnings, and other market participants. Now, when it comes to rebalancing, we may consider exiting a stock if, the company's capital allocation policy has changed or the company enters into an unrelated industry or some large competitor enters the sector. We may also choose to replace a current stock if there are companies or sector with better growth prospects or there are sectors which, you know, clearly have better tailwinds or better capital allocation. Also, when, you know, there's a hypothesis with which we invest in a stock, if that plays out, then, you know, we may choose to exit the stock. Now, if you take the performance of the Tezi Mandi portfolio, you know, this has performed across almost any time period you can think of, you know, and that's why, you know, and it's obviously outperformed the underlying benchmark in a meaningful way. So, you know, how much is it that we charge? You know, as I said, like, we have a really accessible price point. So we charge as low as 149 per month if you take the 1 month plan. And, you know, it goes up all the way to 249 if you take the, it's 149 per month if you take the 6 month plan, and it's 249 if you take the 1 month plan. Good thing is we don't charge you based on your investment amount. You can invest as much as you want. Our prices remain the same. Now, what is it that you get when you pay for Tezi Mandi? You get access to an actively managed Tezi Mandi portfolio, which is, 15 to 20 stocks. You get regular rebalances. You get regular portfolio updates on stocks. The rationale behind why we tell you to buy or sell those stocks. And we also, it's simple one-click buy, sell, and rebalance facility. Also, we have kind of daily materials that we write, like three things to know, deep sector dive. So, and even the rationales for when you invest in the stocks, you know, there's a great way for you to learn how to, you know, invest in the market and become a better investor. So with that, I'd like to open up the floor for Q&A, and if you want, you can use this barcode to download our app. I would urge you to download the app and take access to a subscription. I promise you will not be disappointed. You know, this is a great time to invest in the market. I would, encourage you to consider doing the same through Tezi Mandi. Thank you.
Thanks, Vaibhav. For any questions that you have, guys, you can put it in the Q&A section. I think some of you have already been asking some questions, but before we start the Q&A, I urge you to please restrict questions to investing in stocks and equities only. That's basically our area of expertise. Anything outside that might be a little difficult for us to answer. We also cannot talk about specific stocks in our portfolio, and we cannot tell you which stocks to buy and sell during this webinar. While we can give you a general outlook of the market, we cannot predict how it will behave in the coming days. Nobody actually in the world can. Lastly, we are glad to answer all the questions. This is a very good opportunity for you guys to directly talk to the founding team of Tezi Mandi. So please go ask away. We'll run the Q&A for about maybe 30 to 40 minutes until we kind of exhaust all the questions. Thanks. Okay. So let me just quickly go through the questions. So Anonymous has asked, I am only 15 right now. How can I start investing in stocks?
I think, it's a relevant question. At 15, it might be difficult for you to have your own personal stockbroking account. But if you can, with the help of your parents, open a account, I would suggest that you should, there are a lot of good videos of experts on YouTube. You should start reading books like, One Up on Wall Street and Intelligent Investor by Benjamin Graham. That would definitely give you, a significant kind of edge when you become older. So it's important that you build your foundation right now. Maybe once you're a little more confident, then you should start investing on your own.
Is it a good time to invest in the pharma sector right now during the second wave of COVID?
I mean, yes, you can do a positional trade in pharma right now. I mean, the peak of pharma honestly was March to September of last year. There are some good large cap pharma companies that are good compounders. So you can consider investing in them, but again, it's a personal choice. You might also want to see, because a lot of pharma companies have rich valuations. So you might want to take that call.
Okay. How will you help us if the market crashes during the lockdown?
Yeah, so you know, we have a disciplined rebalancing policy. So, you know, in case if things go completely out of hand and completely, you know, in an uncharted, unprecedented territory, then we will you know, liquidate some of the investments and kind of sit you know, on cash or liquid ETFs. And we're of course watching the market. So be rest assured. I mean, if anything untoward happens, we will take what is required to be done. But at this point, you know, we don't think that you have to be unduly concerned.
Okay. Vishal has asked, is the flagship worthy of a lump sum or an SIP investment? On the day of rebalancing, is there a specific time that we should do the rebalancing?
Yeah. So, you know, you should not, again, try to time any of these things. You know, I would encourage you to start an SIP with flagship. If you do have, you know, like an investable surplus that you can invest, I mean, of course, you should consider doing that. And if you prefer doing an SIP, you can do that as well. In terms of the rebalances, you know, it would be better if you could do it when you get the notification. You know, there is no right time of the day or right time of the year to do it. I mean, you should do it when you're advised by us to do so.
I also see a bunch of you have asked a similar question. So as Vaibhav said, there is no right time or timing. The time in the market. The more time you are in the market is what you have to do, and you have to start as early as possible. So I'm going to be skipping some of these questions. So Anonymous is asking, like, why in your portfolio are you rebalancing so often? Is there a solution you have for predictions and analysis for long-term investors?
Yeah, so, you know, I think the part of the portfolio that rebalances a little more frequently are the tactical bets. Now, what you must realize is that, you know, the situation for the second wave of COVID has also been very dynamic. Also, the opportunity set of stocks kind of changes very rapidly. So what we've done in the last 2-3 weeks, probably for some of the tactical bets, might seem to you that we are changing, but our core portfolio remains the same. We don't change that at all. You know, the tactical bets is maybe what from time to time might change. But that is something that you should not worry about. You know, I would suggest that you follow our advice, because you know, that your portfolio will constantly be pruned and optimized accordingly.
Okay. So Ravi Kiran is asking, I know anybody in the field cannot guarantee the returns that they can produce, but down the lines, what are the expected returns for the Tezi Mandi portfolio 5 years from now?
Yeah, so, you know, as we pointed out earlier, the market has given you about 12%. So over a period of time, we would aspire to get 15 to 18%. But again, this is a long-term kind of a thing. You know, there will be years which are very good. There are years which will not be so good. But over a period of time, I think 15 to 18% is what you should expect.
Anonymous is asking, can NRIs invest in the Tezi Mandi portfolio?
So I think at this point, you know, we are open for Indian citizens. I mean, if you have, you know, depending as an NRI, I mean, if you're an Indian citizen, you know, you can maybe invest. But if you are, you know, a foreign citizen with an Indian PIO kind of card, then it might be difficult for you to invest. I mean, we are only going by what the SEBI regulations tell us. So that's how it is.
Can we have the portfolio saved in the app and see its growth every time? Yeah, you can actually track the portfolio within our app, Raj. So once you use the app, I guess you will understand that's the main aspect of the app. Does Tezi Mandi recommend multi-baggers for medium or long-term investment?
So, you know, the word multi-bagger, I think, is a bit misunderstood. I mean, for multi-baggers, you know, it's not an outcome. It is it's something that happens in hindsight. You cannot buy a stock that it's a multi-bagger or you know it is going to be a multi-bagger. So you have to wait for that kind of time period for stocks to do well for you. The flagship portfolio has a mix of kind of good quality, large caps, small caps, and mid caps. So you should invest in the portfolio through the Tezi Mandi app. However, if you are looking for a high quality small and mid cap portfolio, which has about 12 stocks, we have something called the multiplier portfolio, which you can access separately. I think our team can probably put the link out and share it with you individually if you'd like. But that is where maybe you get access to, you know, the mid and small cap kind of stocks, which are likely to kind of compound at slightly higher returns than what the multi-cap portfolio does.
A lot of you are actually asking about how to get started. I think Tezi Mandi is actually designed specifically for this aspect as well. We kind of simplify investing in the stock market. So they can start, you can obviously get started with us directly. Okay. Is there a right time to top up on my portfolio or when do I invest more in the portfolio?
I think you should invest right away. I mean, you know, as I'm saying, like the current opportunities are a great way for you to get started and to remain invested in the market. You know, we are sitting on kind of a, you know, economic and earnings upcycle over the next, you know, 5 to 7 years. And if you invest now, you know, it's, you know, you will be rewarded well. I obviously can't say it with 100% certainty, but at least if we go by the data and how things are, so you should invest your money, you should top up, you should start an SIP, whatever you're comfortable with. If you have an investable surplus, invest more money, but please remain invested and you know, if you're sitting on the fences, then, you know, kind of, you know, at least take the first step forward.
The TM app has classified me as a moderate risk investor. Can I change my status or the stock recommendation the same for all risk types in the app?
No, so we have, based on your risk profile, we have different model portfolios. I think the risk profile is based on your answers to our questions. So it may not be so easy to, if you want to change your if you want to change your risk profile, you know, that is something I think that you can't do. That is something that we assess. And so that's how we've kind of recommended the model portfolio for you.
Yeah. So some of the guys are actually asking that they cannot have certain stocks in the portfolio due to insider trading regulations. So for you guys, basically, we do provide an option where you can exclude specific stocks while buying in the portfolio. So when we actually push out our advice, you just need to exclude these stocks and kind of remove them from the portfolio. That is definitely possible. It might affect the overall returns, but that is right now the only way. Thank you. Why is there no metal sector stock in your portfolio? So we actually can't talk about specific stocks in our portfolio. It's allocated based on the overall, we can talk a bit about our.
Coming to metals, I think, you know, metals has been in the news of late quite a bit. But there was a point in time when we had we had exposure to some metal stocks, but we've stayed away from it because, you know, the situation is very volatile. Metal prices, while they're also high, it's also very kind of volatile. So, you know, as an investor, we did take advantage of the early cyclical upturn, we aren't sure of, you know, what the trajectory would be kind of going forward because, a lot of the metal stocks have already built in a lot of optimism. And so, you know, whether or not it's the right time to remain invested, And you know, it also tends to cause some volatility in the portfolio. So that's why we chose to remain away from it.
So Rohan is asking, how will I get the portfolio stocks, rebalancing and everything? So we actually do everything through our app. So you can access all of the aspects through our app, through WhatsApp and SMS. And we don't do anything on SMS right now. WhatsApp and email is something that we send as a notification. But all the actions and everything happen through our app. So what I suggest, you can download our app and do the tracking aspect through the app itself. Do you have a target versus the benchmark through Tezi Money?
Do we have a target? I didn't follow the question.
Do you have a return target versus the benchmark?
I think we answered this question before. I think someone had asked what's the return here. So over a period of time, we look to you know, make 15 to 18% over a period of time. You know, but that is by no means a guarantee or a guidance. I mean, it is just you know, an indicative number, because again, markets are volatile. Markets are, you know, kind of pretty crazy as you can see. But what we can tell you is that, you know, it is likely that we're sitting on a, you know, earnings upcycle. And so usually in periods like these, markets tend to be exuberant, and that's when you make good returns as well. So at least that's our view. Markets do look at an interesting phase. You know, we should look to buy in any correction. So we hope and we expect that we should do well, but we cannot guarantee it or kind of give you any guidance.
Vaibhav Gupta is asking, I understand that you only have one offering, but it does get rebalanced quite regularly. Is there a chance you're launching another product for long term with minimal rebalancing?
So, you know, as I said, you know, the rebalances happen not because we like to rebalance something necessarily. I mean, if it was up to us, we would just, you know, completely sit still. But what you have to understand is that the part of the portfolio which is tactical bets, they tend to change based on the market situation a little bit as well. And so, you know, if you don't agree with some of the advice that we give you, I mean, it's a non-discretionary advice. So what that means is that we will give the advice, but ultimately you have to approve it and execute it at your end. So, so at that point, you can choose not to execute it if you don't agree with us. So the way the portfolio is designed is for you to help you make money in the long term, right? And so that's why, you know, it is a product for the long term. So that's why I don't think you should be unduly concerned about rebalances happening from time to time. I mean, that's only done to optimize the portfolio. In case if you're looking for, you know, a longer term, higher risk portfolio, we have our multiplier offering as well, which we offer through a platform called Smallcase. I think our team can share those details with you. But again, that is meant for a slightly longer term, slightly higher risk kind of appetite. So that is a discretion that you would have to take.
So Bhavin is asking that how often do you review the portfolio? Is it being looked at every week?
Bhavin, we are looking at the portfolio at all times. You know, as I've explained the investing process earlier as well. So we are looking at it at all times. I mean, you know, we only act when we find a very compelling reason to do so. So that's important for you to understand.
Also, Bhavin, you have to understand that we do send out weekly updates on most of the stocks in the portfolio, because and we are actively reviewing each and every aspect about the portfolio. So every weekend you'll actually get an update from us about the portfolio. Let me see some. I've currently invested in Tezi Mandi. Some stocks are making good returns and some stocks are very poor. What is happening with these stocks? Kiran has asked this question.
Yeah, so you should understand that, you know, that's how you have a portfolio of stocks. What ends up happening is that, you know, from time to time, there will be some stocks that are performing, there are some that are not performing. But that doesn't mean that you exit those stocks, you know, till we don't advise you to do so. It could be that those stocks are in a period of consolidation you know, they're just kind of, markets don't kind of work in a linear form. You know, like stocks will do well for a period of time and then they'll consolidate. So it is likely that they're consolidating. So, you know, you should remain patient. You should look at your overall portfolio return, because ultimately that is what is the main thing. So that's how I would kind of advise you to approach it.
Ankita Sethi has asked, how do you compare the market downtrends which took place in 2020 compared to the ones in 2008 and 2001?
The 2008 crash was obviously similar to the great recession of 2008. So what we saw last year was kind of similar to that, but last year was a health crisis and a financial crisis. 2001, on the other hand, was the end of the dot-com boom. The dot-com boom, kind of the crash happened because of overvaluation in markets. The great kind of recession happened because of, you know, financial stocks. There was just a lot of leverage in the system. And this one happened not because of that. This happened because of, the advent of a pandemic. So it's very different from the crash of 2001 and 2008. If that's what you're asking.
Okay. Rupesh has asked, I subscribe to Tezi Mandi via small case. Can I transfer the subscription to your app? So Rupesh, actually you cannot do that very seamlessly right now. You can't transfer your portfolio if you have invested in it already. But you can definitely cancel your subscription in small case and subscribe through the app again. Both the portfolios are basically the same. You can use either. So you can take a call, whichever you prefer, but yeah, you cannot, anything that has been bought through small case cannot be used, through our app, cannot be accessed through our app. Is there a recommended portfolio allocation that we should have during this time, in equities, debt, gold, ETFs, etc.?
There is no right allocation. But I think one benchmark that one rule of thumb that people use for equities is that your age, 100 minus your age is what you should invest. So like, let's say you're 20 years old. 100 minus 20, so 80% should be in equities and the remaining should be in debt and other instruments. That's just a rule of thumb that some people use. But obviously, the call would depend on your risk appetite, what you're looking to achieve, all of that. So, you should definitely have some exposure to equities, because equities are one of the only liquid ways in which you can beat inflation in a meaningful manner. And they help you create long-term wealth, especially if you're invested in the right stocks. So that's how you should definitely have exposure to equities. Now, how much obviously would depend from person to person. Okay.
Just going through a few of the questions. A lot of them are common. Hold on. So how many stocks are there in the portfolio if I invest, say, 40 to 50 lakhs? Sean has asked this question.
So as of today, there are about 16 stocks in the portfolio. You can invest as much as you would like. There's no limit to how much you can invest. Depending on your broker, you can invest through the app, and that would be the most advisable option.
Do you recommend adding a few of my own stocks to this portfolio? Vaibhav Gupta has asked this question.
So what we would suggest is that you keep that our portfolio, you keep the way it is suggested to you. And if you want to buy into any of your own stocks, I mean, you can definitely do that in your own personal capacity in your DMAT account. There's absolutely nothing that stops you from doing that, but we should not mix it up with our portfolio.
A lot of you have asked about penny stocks. Maybe you can quickly talk about penny stocks and why they could be problematic.
Penny stocks, a lot of people get fascinated by the fact that, penny stocks, you kind of enter it at say 2 rupees and it becomes 2.5. So you make 40% return. But what you have to realize is that penny stocks, one, come with their own risk. Two is that, they are penny stocks for a reason, because either the capital allocation policies are bad or, the companies are just doing things which by design don't make them scalable. So if these companies had good growth or they were scalable and they had good corporate governance, they would not be penny stocks, right? So that's why penny stocks are, and they're also very speculative, very volatile. So, if you would like to take a punt in one of them just for having fun, that's a very different thing. But if you want to create long-term wealth, then obviously that's a very different ballgame altogether. So, we are in the, we are in the field to help you make, create long-term wealth. And that is why kind of we would recommend you to stay away from penny stocks.
Sean has asked, I have an MO broking account. Your app is not allowing us to need to invest in your portfolio.
Yeah, so the thing is that SEBI has come out with a regulation that the investment advisory and broking has to be there has to be a clear Chinese word. That's why if you have an MO broking account, unfortunately we can't let you invest through our app. But you can search for the Prime portfolio in the IP section of the broking app, and that's where we have an offering.
Do you employ any AI or machine learning while rebalancing? Vishal, we don't actually do any AI or machine learning based thing. We have actually real people kind of looking at each and every decision. So you can be rest assured that it's a, there's a human involved in each and every aspect about a portfolio. I think somebody has asked, your past returns show around 70 to 80%. I think on small case, they show 35%. How many years were considered for this CAGR?
So right now, like the portfolio in its current form went live in March last year. But what you have to realize is that, we have fund management experience of over a decade. And so there were other portfolios that were seeded at other points in time. And so those returns have done very well. But the portfolio in its current shape is an evolution of all the learnings we've had over that time period, which is why you're seeing the current return. So what Smallcase is saying at 37% is, obviously something that they've considered from a CAGR point of view. They've recently changed their calculation methodology. What you might also want to look at is the total return that we've had, which currently stands at about 86% since March of last year. So, I mean, that's how I would kind of look at it.
So somebody has asked, what is the normal proportion of large cap, mid cap and small cap in your portfolio? Is there a specific proportion that you follow for this?
So we don't follow a specific proportion. Right now, we are about 45% large cap, about 25% mid cap, and maybe another 25-30% of small cap.
Do you buy the recommended stock and show it in our account on the app? Yeah, so we actually link with brokers directly on the app. So we have around 10 brokers which we link with directly, and we can show you the investments made in the portfolio through our app itself. And in terms of, I guess Mohit has asked, so I'll quickly answer that question as well. What is the difference between the portfolio on Smallcase and on the app? I mean, the portfolios are both the same. Even on Smallcase, you'll pay the same subscription fee as what you would pay on the app. So it's more or less the same. I think a lot of people have been asking.
Sorry, just one thing I'd like to add to Smallcase. We have our multiplier offering as well over there, which is the mid and small cap portfolio. So you might, so that's currently not available on the app. If you'd like to invest in that, then you could look at the Smallcase portal for that.
Okay, Webber, a lot of people are actually asking if there are any books that you recommend that they read for investing in the stock market. So maybe you can quickly re-answer that question one more time.
I mean, there are lots and lots of books that you can read, of course. You know, the classic one is Intelligent Investor by Benjamin Graham. You can also read, the yearly shareholders letters of Warren Buffett. They've got priceless wisdom in them. You can also read One Up on Wall Street by Peter Lynch. So I think these two, three books are all-time classics. I mean, they're relevant. They were relevant whenever they were written, and they're going to be relevant for a long time from now as well.
What happens if I don't renew my subscription after 3 or 6 months? Vipul Khanna is asking this question.
So if you don't renew it, you don't get access to our advice. And so what ends up happening is that whenever we prune the portfolio or optimize it, you don't get access to those to that advice. And so obviously while the current stocks will help you make money, but what we suggest is that you remain kind of subscribed to us, because one, the subscription rate is really nominal. And two is, you know, it is better for you to kind of get those updates and execute them so that you are on the right track.
Okay. Can we expect a similar CAGR in the future?
I guess, you know, this question's been asked today previously as well. You know, the market has given you about 12% over the last 50 years. We cannot give a guarantee. We cannot give a guidance. We will kind of try and look at, you know, helping you make between 15 to 18% over a period of time. What we think, though, is that since you're sitting at the bottom of an economic cycle and earning cycle, and the next 3 to 5 years are going to look very promising, we expect that we should be able to better those returns. And so you should be able to do well if you remain invested with us. But again, that's only an indication I can give. By no means is it a guarantee or a guidance.
Will I get tips or calls on WhatsApp? I guess maybe we can just in a bunch answer this question. Basically, we do not give tips or calls. We also don't believe in that sort of a concept, because those are very short term. And we also don't do futures and options trading. We only focus on the equity market. I think all of this has been covered in the presentation. We'll also be uploading this presentation on YouTube, so you can go through it one more time. You guys should know that in the end, the stocks are held in your broking account very safely. We don't hold any of your portfolio. We are only an advisory product, right? So we can't do anything like in terms of executing on your behalf or anything. It's all held by you. Even the actual execution of the rebalance advice is all happening through your account, through your permission. So all of these aspects, this is exactly what the product is for. It gives you a more control, like a better understanding of investing in stocks. Something, I guess, like which other products usually don't give you. You have obviously our advisory team, which keeps on sending you updates every weekend on Saturday about the stocks which are there in the portfolio. So you can also make more informed choices. Yeah, I think we pretty much have run out of questions. Weber, maybe you can talk about this buy on dips. I think a few people are asking about when to invest more again. So maybe we can talk about this buy on dip strategy once, and then
So I think if you look at we've kind of shown previously as well that every correction is an opportunity for you to remain to buy into the market. And so buy on dips is nothing but kind of buying in the market correction. So so investing more in the correction will only help you make more returns in the long term. And we think that next 2 to 5 years looks kind of very promising for the stock market. So you should consider investing at every opportunity that you get.
Yeah, I think we are pretty much done in terms of the questions. Thank you guys for attending the webinar with us. We will definitely be conducting more such webinars in the future on various topics. You can definitely reach out to us as well, like in terms of suggestions for for topics that we can cover in more detail. But yeah, it was good having you all. Thanks for your questions as well. Most of them were very, very good. And I hope we've answered them to your satisfaction. So yeah, cool.
Thanks a lot, guys. Thanks.